हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम मुंशी राठौर फ्रॉम एसवी काडा आर्ट्स एंड पीके पटेल कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स नवसारी। फ्रेंड्स, आई एम स्टूडेंट ऑफ टीवाईपीए इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ डॉल्स हाउस रिटन बाय द नॉर्वेजियन प्ले राइटर हेनरिक इब्सेन। इट वॉज पब्लिश्ड इन 21st December 1879। इट इज अ 3-act प्ले। फ्रेंड्स, द ड्रामा बिगिंस विद द क्रिसमस ईव। अ डे बिफोर क्रिसमस इज कॉल्ड क्रिसमस ईव। टुमारो विल बी अ क्रिसमस। Friends, Nora is preparing for Christmas. Nora is coming with many gifts for their husband and their children. When Nora's husband Torvald saw the gift, he told Nora that don't spend too much money. Friends, Nora's husband spends money when it indeed. Friends, Nora and their husband are quarreling in some small talks often. Friends, here after some time, there are two guests come to Nora's home. Among them, the first is Dr. Rank and the second is Christine Linde. Dr. Rank is Torvald's close friend. He went to Torvald's study room with a view to spending time with Torvald. Friends, here, Christine Linde. When Christine Linde comes, Nora could not be able to identify her. But after some time, Nora comes to realize that Christine Linde was her school friend. Friends, Nora feels very happy. They are meeting after very long time. Christine tells Nora that her husband passed away. And when her husband passed away, she didn't have any money or she didn't have any child to support her. Friends, Nora also told Christine that when she got married, they were very poor. Nora and Torvald walks round the clock to run home. After that, Torvald becomes ill and they migrate to Italy for their treatment. Now, Nora asks Christine, tell me what is going on in your life. And Christine explains with sorrowness that she has been working for her older mother. And she has also the younger brothers to take care of. Now, her mother is no more. And her younger brothers do not require the Christine anymore. Now, Christine tells Nora that, I don't have any job. Can you please tell your husband to give me a job? Nora promises Christine that she will talk to her husband. After that, Nora tells Christine one mystery. When she went to Italy for Torvald's treatment, she borrowed some money. And still, she is working to repay their money. Friends, Nora also tells Christine that Torvald didn't know this mystery. He told him that Pony's treatment was given by her father. Friends, at the one side, Nora and Christine are talking. Simultaneously, the another guest come, and that is Krogstad. Krogstad is the person who is working in the same bank where Nora's husband worked. Friends, Krogstad works under the Torvald helmet. Nora sends Krogstad in the study room. Nora feels uncomfortable after seeing Krogstad. Now, three guests are coming from the study room. Among them, Dr. Rank, Torvald and Krogstad. Nora introduces Christine to the Torvald. She is in search of job. So, is there any vacancy in your bank? Torvald replies Nora that he will see and then he will tell you. Now, after that, three guests are departed. Now, Nora's children come to home with their granny and Mary. Nora is playing with their children. At that time, she comes to realize that still, Krogstad is not departed. He is still there. Now, Nora went to Krogstad and told him that Torvald is not at home. Krogstad told Nora that he wants to talk with you. Your husband, today, tomorrow or the day after tomorrow will dismissal me from my job. I wish you can talk with your husband to save my job. Nora replies that, how can I talk with Torvald? It is your professional matter. Friends, now Krogstad start blackmailing Nora. Krogstad tells Nora that I know very well about the mystery. You borrowed some money for Torvald's treatment and you told Torvald that it was given by your father and you are still working to repay that borrowed money. Friends, here Nora thinks that Torvald is quarreling with me in some small talks. So I don't know what he reacts when he comes to know that I hide this mystery and I lie to him. Here, Krogstad departs. Torvald comes to home. Nora requests him not to dismiss Krogstad from the job. But Torvald tells Nora that Krogstad is an idiot person and I feel physically weak in front of his presence. The next day, Nora again tries to save Krogstad's job, but Torvald gives the dismissal letter to the maid to deliver the Krogstad and Torvald departs. After a while, Krogstad comes to Nora and tells her, Nora, what is this? Your husband has dismissed me. After some time, Krogstad has returned the mystery in one single letter and put it in the letterbox, and then Krogstad departs. Now Torvald and Christine come to home. Nora is in stress, so Nora reveals everything in front of Christine, and Christine went to Krogstad to convince him. Nora starts performing the tarantella dance, but Torvald dislikes the dance. Nora keeps the promise from the Torvald that he won't open the letterbox till tomorrow. The next day, Christine meets Krogstad. When Christine and Krogstad are talking to each other, readers think that they have been lovers in the past. The only reason why Christine didn't marry to Krogstad is that she found a rich man. But now, Christine tells Krogstad that I am single and I want to live with you. After hearing that, Krogstad feels very happy. And Krogstad tells Christine that he will replace the letter in which he has revealed the truth. But Christine refuses to do so. Yes friends, Christine refuses to do so as she believes that Nora has been suffocating. It is better to reveal the truth. After that, Torvald has read the letter. He becomes so furious. Torvald scolds Nora so much that he crosses all his limits. Torvald tells Nora that you are a liar. You spoiled all my happiness. And from now, don't take care of my children. I will take care of my children. Nora only hears Torvald with patience. And simultaneously, the maid comes with one more letter. In that letter, Krogstad reveals that I have blackmailed Nora, so please forgive her. After reading that another letter, Torvald becomes quiet. But the words that are spoken by the Torvald cannot be taken back. Friends, now Nora tells Torvald that it has been 8 years of our marriage and still we don't understand each other. Friends, Nora tells Torvald that you treat me like a doll. Yes, you treat me like a doll, and for me, here comes the title. I am a doll for you. As the dolls have no feelings, I have also no feelings. And whatever your heart says, you play with me. After saying this golden sentence, Nora departs, and here ends the drama. Now friends, let's talk about some moral lessons that I have personally learned from Nora's character and Torvald's character. So the moral lesson I personally learned from Nora Helmer's character is that if someone makes you miserable more than they make you happy, it doesn't matter how much you love them, you need to let them go. Friends, the lesson I learned from Torvald's character is that Don't treat people as bad as they are, but treat them as good as you are.